don't think there's anything controversial about it.
Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are calling for an end to structural racism in Britain. As October kicks off Black History Month in the UK, the couple partnered with the Evening Standard to reveal their list of next-generation Black trailblazers who are challenging prejudice and making a positive influence on British culture. The pair also spoke about the impact of the Black Lives Matter movement in the United States and around the world.
We had the fortune of talking to very early on this year when the Black Lives Matter, when the racial justice movement in the U.S. was coming to a head after the murder of George Floyd. We spoke with Alicia Garza, one of the founders of Black Lives Matter. And as she could reiterate, the impetus is really just about reminding people of your worth. And I think, you know, as we've seen different iterations of it, what has been inflammatory, I think, for a lot of people is when any version of a community becomes disruptive, but when there's just peaceful protest and when there's the intention of just wanting unity and wanting the recognition of equality, then that is a beautiful thing.
During the conversation, the Duke of Sussex candidly addressed his eye-opening experience of understanding racism and white privilege.
I've had an awakening as such of my own because I wasn't aware of so many of the issues and so many of the problems within the UK, but also globally as well. I thought I did, but I didn't. And this isn't about pointing the finger, this isn't about blaming anybody, this is just about using this opportunity this month, as I said, to introduce Brits to other Brits that they might not know about or they might not have heard about. And I think the power of community that comes from that is absolutely vast, especially for young Black men and young Black girls.
Well, and I think also what it does is just remind people of our shared humanity. Yeah. And that's the takeaway. It's educational, but it's also really exciting just to find more people in the community that are inspirational.
At one point in the interview, Meghan and Harry had a brief but adorable interruption from their dog, Guy.
We spoke to Ashley Banjo a few weeks ago, straight after the Britain's Got Talent situation. And, you know, that in itself, I'm sure even just me talking about it will become controversial, but the reality is that, you know, he and his team of guys put on the most amazing display of what of how they saw or how 2020.
My dog is just
The proud parents also took a moment to gush about their one-year-old son, Archie.
We're very lucky with our little one. He's just so busy. He's all over the place. And, this is amazing. He's on our toes, but we're really just so lucky.